Hello, my students in grade 7. How are you? This is Mr. Atal Hamid, your social teacher. Today, inshallah, this is the last lesson in our social book, Unit 8, Lesson 3. The title, as you see, Prehistorical and Historical Eras. Prehistorical and Historical Eras. Today, inshallah, we will focus on four important periods or eras during the old civilizations. Okay, so let's start. So it's an introduction, as you see. The invention of writing is one of the most important inventions in the human history. Okay, because the invention of writing, they considered it a changing point or a point that changed their life. The invention of writing is the most important invention during the old civilizations, because when we will see or discuss now the old eras or the old civilization, they will know, you will know how they live in the past. So the invention of writing, it's a great step in their civilization. So, as usual, we will start to know the lesson objectives. We have four eras, we will focus on them. So, number one, as you see, we have pre-historical eras and historical eras. We divided them into two parts. Pre-historical eras are the Stone Age and Chalcolithic Age. Historical eras or historical civilizations are, or periods, the Bronze Age and Iron Age. Okay, so let's start. The Old Stone Age, it's the first part of our lesson, and it's considered as pre-historical era. The Stone Age lasted almost 2 million years. The Stone Age is divided into three different time periods, which are early, middle, and new, or new. Early, middle, and new. Only I want you to know that the Stone Age, it's when we want to write the definition of the Stone Age, the Stone Age is a pre-historical era that lasted almost 2 million years and divided into three parts. Divided into three parts or periods. Yes, it's some features of life, as you see in the Stone Age. Clothes and homes. If we speak about the clothes, as you see in the left of the slide, the Stone Age people wear animal skins but no shoes. So they depended on the animal skins in their clothes. They also wore jewelry, but made of what? It's a surprise. Made of animal bones and animal teeth. So imagine that they had jewelry but made of animal bones and animal teeth. It's their jewelry. Okay, what about the places or the shelters? The Stone Age people lived in caves, and later in the Stone Age they built huts. Their huts were made of natural materials. Inside the caves, everything was made of stone. So in this period, they depended totally on the animals and the bones of the animals. So they use it as jewelry, I don't know how, and also they use it inside the caves. They use the sticks to make fire to keep warm. Okay, so according to the their clothes. They during the Stone Age, a prehistoric era, they used to wear animal skins. Okay, but no choice as you see now. What about their homes or their houses? The people during the Stone Age, they lived in caves. Let's go to the following slide. Now I want you to write in chat box a sentence describes this picture. What do you think? If you want to describe this picture, yeah, as you see, I will give you half of a minute to write. One sentence describe the picture. Okay, grade 7. This picture refers to the prehistoric era called the Stone Age, that the people were hunters and they depended on animals. They depended on animals in order to eat, in order to make shelters, in order to make clothes. So, if they want to wear, they will depend on animals. If they want to have jewelry and so on, so they also depend on the bones and the teeth of the animals. If they want to make houses, shelters, and so on, also they depended on the animals. Okay, so as you see now, this picture shows to us they were hunters and totally they depended on animals. Okay, it's another information or another description of the Stone Age. The Stone Age was a time thousands of years ago when humans. Now, if you want to write the definition of the Stone Age, you have many kinds or different kinds of definitions. You can write, for example, the Stone Age is a prehistoric age that the people depended totally on animals, for example. So let's read. The Stone Age was a time thousands of years ago when humans lived in caves and their life was very simple. They depended on stones and animals. Okay, they were hunters. You can write also this definition. Okay, it's the Stone Age type. Why is it called the Stone Age? It's called the Stone Age because it's characterized by when early humans, okay, sometimes known as cavemen because they lived in caves, they used stone. They used what? Stones in order to make their tools and weapons. So I think it's so easy why it's called the Stone Age, because they depended on stones in order to make their tools and weapons. Okay, now it's another kind or the next age. Okay, and I want you also to describe and to imagine what is the difference between this picture and the last one. This is the second age or era, Chalcolithic age. Okay, they lightly improved in their life. Okay, and as you see in this picture, they started to use some tools. And it's the second prehistoric era. This age started in India. Chalcolithic age started in India. Okay, and they used metals. They used what? Metal. Metals like copper and its alloy bronze are melted at low temperature. Okay. So, if we speak about the second prehistorical era, which called Chalcolithic Age, it's located in India. It's located in India. Why they called it Chalcolithic Age or era? Because the people at this time, they depended on metals, or they started to use metals, okay? Also, they can call it Copper Age or Chalcolithic period or era, okay? Was an era of transition, كتحول أو انتقال, between the stone tool using farmers of the Neolithic and the metal obsessed civilizations of the age of the Bronze Age. So, because Bronze Age, it will be a historical era. So, the Chalcolithic era or the Copper Age, because we can use the two definitions, is the transition from prehistorical to historical era, because now you will see the first historical era. Okay, what is the main point here? During the Chalcolithic era, the people started to use metals, and Chalcolithic era located in India. It's the first historical era, as you see, Bronze Age. Bronze Age is the first historical era. So now we talk two prehistorical eras. Now the first historical era, Bronze Age. Okay, describe the picture, please. Write your answers. Only one sentence. Write it in chat box now. Okay. The Bronze Age is a historical period that was characterized by the use of bronze. It's according to their name, to its name. And in some areas, proto writing and other early features of urban civilization. Okay. Although the Iron Age generally followed the Bronze Age in some areas, like some areas in Africa, the Iron Age began as early as 2500 BC. So, the Bronze Age, you can write the definition. What is the Bronze Age? It's the first historical era, and it was characterized by the use of bronze. 5 greatest civilizations during the Bronze Age. You can write only write 3. You can write 3. Okay, you can choose 3. Bronze Age, for example, ancient civilizations, ancient civilization, Chinese civilization, Arabian civilization. If you can memorize the 5, it's okay, or you can write 3. For example, you can. It's according to the name, so you can write Bronze Age, Chinese civilization, and European civilization. What about the life during the Bronze Age? By the start of the Bronze Age, people in Britain had learned to tame horses. And also they learned to make carts with wheels, as you see here in this line. They learned to make carts with wheels. Some farmers traveled on horseback or used wooden carts. So now they improved. So you can see the difference between the prehistorical eras, which they lived in caves and used stones, and now they traveled by wooden carts. Okay. And it's pulled by horses or oxen. So the first war cart appeared at the end of the Bronze Age. Okay, So now you can speak about a kind of improvement, a kind of improvement during the Bronze Age. The last one is the Iron Era. Okay, as usual, please describe the picture. Okay, please try to read. Yeah, it's the last era or the last period, and it's the second historical era. The Iron Age is the name given to the time period from 500 BC to 43 AD in Britain, where iron became the preferred choice of metal for making tools. In Europe, the Iron Age marks the end of prehistory after the Stone Age and the Bronze Age. So the Iron Age, you can say that it's the first step of development. Okay, and it also put the end or marks the end of the prehistory era. What did Iron Age people eat? As you see, they ate crops like wheat, beans, okay? They also ate meat, like the sheep meat, the cheap meat, and the meat from the pigs, okay? So during the prehistorical eras, they depended totally in the animals. They depended on the animals, houses, shelter, jewelry, food, and so on. Now, it's a kind of development you can speak about it. So they started to eat crops like wheat. They started to eat meat like sheep meat and pig's meat. Okay. Also, the people during the Iron Age, they started to speak more than one language, okay? Because they started to travel from one place to another. And it's the second historical age. You can speak about some kind of development in this era, okay? It's our lesson today, grade 7. We focus on four historical, prehistorical and historical eras, two during prehistorical and two during historical eras. Okay, I hope that all of you understand the points in this lesson. And if you misunderstand any point, you can call me. And also it's Unit 8, Lesson 3, the last lesson in our book. I hope all of you good and stay safe, stay home. After 2 days, okay, I think after tomorrow, yes, after tomorrow, we will have the last revision. And we will focus, inshallah, we will focus on Unit 8 lessons. Okay, we will revise the three lessons in Unit 8. Okay, your homework today is write or compare the difference between the prehistorical eras and the historical eras. Again, your homework today, compare or mention or write the difference between the prehistorical eras and the historical eras. You have two periods or two ages, okay, in during prehistorical, and two ages, two eras or ages during historical periods. So please tell me the difference between them and send me your answers on WhatsApp. Okay, it's our lesson today, grade 7. Okay, see you after tomorrow, inshallah.